Hi students, good morning. Welcome to English class. Last day we discussed the first four paragraphs of the story, The Light on the Hills. Can you recollect the main points? Okay, a boy wanted to draw the picture of a field. So he went into a field to draw the picture. Then who was with him? His little sister. And she gave him a number of suggestions to make his picture more beautiful. And also we saw that she had a very positive attitude. She told that if he do something beautifully, it would make others happy. Okay, so this nature is very beautiful. So we have to make others happy by drawing beautiful pictures. If you do something badly, or if you represent the world badly or imperfectly, it is a sin. That's what the boy understood from the words of his sister. And then what did we see? Okay, the boy was tired. They wanted to go back home. And then he told that, or this girl suggested that if anybody has to do anything beautiful, he or she should do it for the people whom they love. Then what did the boy tell? Okay, if I have to draw a picture, I will think of you and I will draw it. And we understood that the boy loved his sister very much. Okay, up to that we have completed. So we'll come to the fifth paragraph. So once more they looked at the hills that seemed to rise up out of the deep shadow into the light. And then together they went home. Together, that means both of them. This boy and his little sister, both of them went by home. But then what happened? It is mentioned a tragedy happened. Soon afterwards, a big tragedy struck their family. A very, very unhappy incident happened there. Do you know what was that? That is mentioned in the next line. One night when the family was sleeping, the little sister died in her sleep. So what's the tragedy mentioned here? That the death of this little girl. So we know that's a real tragedy, a death. If someone dear to us dies, it will be really unbearable. It will be painful. And here in the case of this family also, the death of this little girl was unbearable, painful. So no doubt it was a tragedy. And we know that this boy loved his loved his sister very much. So we cannot measure the sorrow of this boy. The mother explained to the brother, "Son, your little sister wandered into another world and journeyed on so far that she lost the clue to earth and could not be back anymore." These were the words of his mother about the death of this girl. She journeyed into another world and she cannot come back. Okay, so however, it was very unhappy, and all the members of the family were very sad, and the boy also. The boy, who was grieving for his little sister, painted many pictures before he could gather the courage to see the same field that he saw with his sister once again. So grieving, are you familiar with the word grief? GRIEVE. That's the spelling. And the noun form, grief. 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 Noun form. Verb form, GRIEVE. What's the meaning of grieve? To feel sad. And here, why was he feeling sorrow, sadness? What was the reason? Okay, the death of his sister. So he was very sad. So it is mentioned that as he was very sad, he couldn't go to the field. Again, we know that they had gone to the field to draw the picture, and he hadn't completed the picture, but he hadn't the courage to go to the field again. That means it is not the matter of courage, more than that. That shows that he was very sad. So if he goes to the place again, it will make him more sad, because he will think of their coming to the field and the words of his sister, and also he couldn't go there, and he painted many other pictures before he completed this picture. So he could go to that field after many years, it is mentioned. But after many years, as he sat and worked, a strange power came to him. Can you imagine what will be the strange power came to him? Okay, I think that may be the thought about his sister. The words of his sister might have echoed in his ear. Because we know that even though she was a small girl, she had given him a number of points to keep in his mind, that you should do something perfectly to make others happy, and you should, while you do something, you should think of the people whom you love the best, and all these things. He might have thought of all these words. So he got a strange power, it is mentioned. This strong feeling was like an answer to the longing in his heart since his little sister died. A longing, here we can say it's a strong wish. Can you imagine what will be the strong wish mentioned here? Okay, I think it is to, that strong wish was to complete the picture. And why couldn't he complete the picture? Because he couldn't go into the field. Then why couldn't he go into the field? After the death of his sister, he was very sad. So he couldn't go there. But after many years, he decided to complete the picture, and he started the work. The strong feeling was like an answer to the longing in his heart since his little sister died. This emotion seemed to answer a desire in his heart to put into the world something which should make the meanest, humblest citizen a little happier or better. So what was the strong desire in his heart? What was the strong wish? To complete the picture and to make the people happy. Those people who see this picture should be happy. So that also were the words of his sister. While you do something, it should make others happy. Alas, when he knew that his eye was true and his touch sure, he took up the picture he had promised to paint for the dear sister and worked at it until he was finished. That means he started, or he continued drawing the picture while he could control his emotions, while he could control the pain after many years of the death of his sister. This is better than all he has done before, the audience said. It is surely beautiful, for it makes one happy to look at it. What was the comment of the people who saw this picture? They commented that it was very beautiful. It was more beautiful than all the pictures he had drawn. And why did they say that it was beautiful? It made them happy. And we know the secret. He remembered the words of his sister and drew the picture. "And yet my heart ached as I did it," the artist said. Yet my heart ached, A-C-H-E, ache. What's the meaning of ache? Have you heard this word ache? Okay, we use the word headache, stomach ache, etc. So what may be ache? Referring to the pain. Even though all others praised him, he was not happy. He was feeling a pain. And what was the reason? Why was he feeling pain? Okay, he thought of his sister. "I thought of her all the time I worked. I thought of her." Her refers to his sister. "It was the sorrow that gave me power. The power to draw a beautiful picture that would make the people happy. It seemed as if a soft voice of his long dead sister that spoke only to his heart answered back. Not sorrow, but love. And perfect love has all the good qualities in its gift, and from it comes all other things, all things except for happiness." So he could feel a sound. What was that? He felt that his sister was speaking to him. And what were the words? "Not sorrow, but love." We know that if he was feeling sorrow, that was because of his love to his sister. While she died, he became so sad because he loved his sister very much. So, and if you love someone dearly, if you love someone dearly, what will happen? It is mentioned, it has all the good qualities in its gift, and from it comes all other things. All things except for happiness. Why there won't be any happiness? Because here also we know that he thought of the death of his sister. "How does one find happiness?" interrupted the boy. Because we know that he felt his voice and he asked in his mind maybe. What was the question? How does one find happiness? "Finding happiness is a strange case," the answer seemed to be. "If you want to find it for one's own self, then one must seek it for others. How can you get happiness? You yourself cannot be happy. How can you be happy? You must try to find happiness for others. You should try to make others happy. And while you see the happiness of others, that will give you happiness." So that also, we know that nobody told him, but he felt that his sister was telling all these things to him. And no doubt that was because of his deep love towards her. "But happiness is so difficult to seize or to find. It is not an easy thing to be happy or to get happiness. And the only means to get happiness, to be happy, is to make others happy. Perfect love helps one to live without happiness," his own heart answered to himself. "And above all things, it helps one to walk and to wait." So if you get the power to do something, if you get the power to walk, that is because of perfect love. So in the beginning also we saw that while you do something, and if you think of the people whom you love, you will be ready to suffer any pain, any difficulties, etc. And only this perfect love will motivate you to do something, and will help you to bear all the pains. "But if it gives one happiness too," he asked eagerly. "While you do work, You should do it for others. You try to make others happiness. And while you do it, if it gives you happiness, if it gives one happiness too, if you get happiness, what is that? Oh, then it is called heaven. It's a blessed state in which you feel love, happiness, peace, harmony, and all these things. Okay, so this is the story of the light on the hills. It's a very simple story. Okay, there is nothing difficult. Number of difficult words also less. So what you have to do now is to read it many times, as many times as possible. And if there is any word that you do not know, learn the spelling, learn the meaning, and also complete the side questions. Okay, you should complete your notebooks. And next week, while we have the Google Meet, I will ask you to show your notebooks. Okay, so you might have, I think you might have completed it. Okay, we will see you next day. Thank you.